my class.
Good morning po, sir.
Good morning. Kindly invite others to join. Thank you.
So, excuse me po, sir. Exam po natin ngayon?
No. Friday. Your exam will be on Friday.
Okay, thank you po, sir.
Thank you.
Our Heavenly Father, the fount of all goodness and grace, the cause of wisdom, the source of intelligence, we welcome you, O Lord, to this auspicious gathering of your beloved, who continuously give you thanks for every opportunity to learn something new and become fruitful to the works of your creation. We humbly come to you, not because we are worthy, but because we find ourselves in need of you, who is our strength and our hope, to continue despite the challenges we face in health, prosperity, and our solidarity with one another. We pray that today's gathering, made possible by the grace of advancements in technology and social media, become successful in its endeavors, so we can offer it back to you as our humble offering to honor you, glorify you, and love you through our deeper connection with everyone. May we find bliss in today's session and become more productive children and co-creators of the earth. This we ask and pray through Christ our Lord. Amen.
So again, good morning, guys. Good morning. Or, Anna.
At least classroom management.
Sige, sa kanila. Dual purpose. Bye-bye. Oh. Hindi ko alam. Pag-usapan natin later. Okay, so again, good morning guys and welcome to our class, no? Discrete math class. This morning, we are going to share to you the principles of accounting, permutations, and combinations na that would be kasi kasama sa coverage natin sa exam natin, no? Kaya left no other choice, kailangan nating madaliin, no? And if I'm not mistaken, in your previous din in your previous class, this has already been discussed, so parang review na nga lang to or mastery na nga lang to. Okay, so again, good morning, and of course in this lesson all you just have to do is just to use your critical thinking skills na for the principles of accounting. So when we talk about principles of accounting, this is the rule, no, that count or that is being used to count the total number of possible outcomes in a situation. No, it say for example, it when we talk about principles of accounting, it states that if there are n ways, no, in doing something, and m ways in doing another thing, no, after that, then there is or there are n times m ways to perform both of these actions. So in order, or in other words, when choosing an options for n and m, okay, there are n times m different ways to perform both actions. So madali lang. So parang multiplication lang, no? So say for example in this case, so we have here Lily is trying to decide what to wear, no? She has shirts in the following colors: red, purple, and blue. And she has pants, no, in the following colors: black and white. So how many different outfits can Lily choose from, assuming she selects one shirt and one pair of pants? Well, guess sa ating chat box. Sige nga. So in this case, there are three options, no, for choosing a shirt and two options in choosing pants. Definitely, gamit yung ating principles of counting formula, which is n times m. Therefore, 3 times 2 is equals to 6, na? 6 total options. Napakadali lang, na? Sobrang dali. Now, kung if we are going to represent, no, yung ating possible options. Say for example, we have ang sinasabi doon, una, we have sa shirt, na? Sa shirts natin. Mayroong red, mayroong blue, mayroong purple. So sa kabila, mayroon din sa pants. So ito yung N natin, represent natin sa N. Ito yung represent ng N. So mayroong ano yan, black and white. So kunyari sa unang ano, puro black muna siya. Ito black, black. Ito naman ang kambarter nito, black pa rin. So another set, red, blue, and purple. So with that, ang kapartner niya ay white pants. So from this illustration, we could be able to, no, as expected, no, there are 6 possible combinations. No? This method we have done in listing method, no? Of course, Lily can choose red and black pair, blue and black pair, purple and black pair, red and white pair, blue and white pair, and purple and white pair. Or simply, 3 times 2, we have 6 possible combinations. So another thing, another example. So, kanina. The role of the product can extend to however many things from, no? So, for example, if there are N choices for a shirt, M choices for a pair of pants, X choices for a pair of shoes, and Y choices for a hat, the role of the product states that there are N times N times X times Y, total possible combinations. Okay, so, multiply lang po ang gagawin natin. So another example, we have here, you go out, no, to check out 3 books at the library. And you want 1 history book, 1 science book, and 1 fantasy book. So the library has 50 history books, 95 fantasy books, and 30 books about science. Tig-isa lang naman, no? Ang gusto niya, no? How many combination of books do you want to choose from? So in this case, madali lang din. Anong gagawin natin dito? Ayan. So we have 50 times 95. Okay, 95 times 30. That will give us how much? I-calculator ninyo.
30,000?
50 times 30, 15 times 95. That's 100.
42,500.
Okay. That's 142,500. So another thing, no, that we are going to do. There are 8 daily newspapers and 5 weekly magazines published in Chicago. If Colin wants to subscribe to exactly 1 daily newspaper and 1 weekly magazine, how many different choices does he have? So, tig-iisa lang din. So, how many choices? Guess? That is?
40.
Okay, that is 40, guys. 8 times 5. Or that is 40. Another thing. Another example. Calvin wants to go to Milwaukee. No? He can choose from 3 bus services, no? And 2 train services to head from home to downtown Chicago. From there, he can choose 2 bus services or 3 train services to choose to head to Milwaukee. How many ways are there for him to get to Milwaukee? Mula sa bahay niya.
36.
Why 36? So in this case, no, we have to analyze the question. Since Calvin can take a bus or train downtown, then he has 3 plus hindi siya multiple, okay, yung rule of the sum naman dito. Sa una, ang unang options niya mula sa bahay nila papuntang downtown Chicago, pwede siyang mag-bus, pwede rin siyang mag-train. So, we have 3 plus 2, definitely that would be 5 na. And another options, mula sa downtown papuntang Milwaukee, pwede siyang mag-bus. May dalawa siyang options at may pwede rin siyang mag-train. Another 3 options. So that is 2 plus 3. Of course, that is 5. Ang tanong, how many ways are there for him to get to Milwaukee now? So that is 5 times 5. That is 25 ways. Now you have to analyze the question. Does the total number of ways for him to head from home to Milwaukee is 25. Another example. For the first set, no? In this case, we have here our problem pala. The problem states that 6 friends, no? Andy, Brandy, Candy, Dandy, Andy, and Fandy wants to set, no, in a row at the cinema. So, anim sila. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, anim. So, if there are only 6 seats available, how many ways can we set these friends? How many ways can we set these friends? So for the first set, we have the choice, no? So para may anim na available, of course, no? Anim na. So for the first set, no? Ilan ang pagpilian natin? Siyempre, anim. That is six. So may anim na upuan. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So sa unang upuan, pagpilian natin, anim. Anim pa sila. Nakaupo na yung isa. Sa susunod na upuan, ilan na lang ang pagpilian natin? 5. Sa susunod na upuan, 4 na lang yung pagpilian natin. Sa susunod na upuan, 3, naging 2, magiging 1. So, using the role of the product, no? Using the role of the product, then there will be how many ways we can set these friends. That is 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. That will give us how many ways? How many ways?
720.
Okay. 720 ways. Ano na, nasaan eh? Okay. That will give us 720 ways. Another example. Suppose Rodrigo is to watch na a K-pop concert at the Ranita Coliseum. No. The Coliseum has 4 gates where he can enter. If he cannot pass through the same gate twice, in how many ways can he enter and leave the Coliseum? So, ilang gate? We have 4 gates. Okay, so hindi siya pwedeng dumaan sa, I mean, kung mag-exit siya, hindi po siya pwedeng mag-exit on the same gate doon sa pinagdaanan niya sa entrance. How many ways he enter and leave the Coliseum? So again, i-represent natin para mas madaling tandaan. So in this problem, we have 4 conditions. The Coliseum has 4 gates. Ang 4 gates na yon represented ng okay, so ang entrance gate natin mayroong so ang gates natin we have ito yung gate, so represent lang natin A, B, C, D. Ayan. So kung ang 4 gates natin, represented natin A, B, C, D. Ayan. 4 na gate. So ang exit route niya, most likely, exit route niya, definitely, ay maaring saan? So ang exit route niya ay maaring sa ito pwedeng sa B, C, D. Ito kung sa B siya mag-enter, ang exit route niya pwedeng sa A, C, D. Pag sa C, ang exit route niya ay pwedeng sa A, B, and D. Pag sa D, A, B, C ang exit route niya. Okay? So, definitely, ano yung magiging route niya, yung pwede niyang pag-exitan. Kung magsimula siya sa A, pwede siya sa A, B, pwede siyang mag-AC, pwede siyang mag-AD. Kung magsimula naman siya sa B, pwede siyang mag-BA, pwede siyang mag BC, pwede siyang mag BD. Sa C naman siya magsimula, pwede siyang mag CA, CB, or CD. Pag D naman siya nagsimula, okay, yung entrance niya, pwede siyang mag DA, DB, pwedeng mag DC. So in this case, using the listing method, okay, in how many ways he can enter and lead the collision, there are 12 possible ways to enter and leave the collision. Okay, so in that case, yeah, na, 4 times 3, actually, that is 12. That will give us 12, okay, definitely. So, using the fundamental or principle of accounting, if one event can occur, no, in M ways and another can occur in N ways, then we can have just, no, like the examples that we have previously, we could just simply may 4 gates, tapos may, okay, sa 4 gates na yan, tatlo ang posible niyang ano, exitan. So definitely, it will give us 12 possible ways for him to exit. Another one, okay. A discrete math class consists of 12 boys and 10 girls. Find the number of ways that the class can elect a president and a vice president. Sige sa ating chat box. Letter A, how many? Sa ating chat box. How many ways that we can select a vice president and vice president? So may dalawang position, no? Ayan. Okay, dalawang position. Sa vice president, okay, 12 boys and 10 girls. Ilang silang lahat? 22. Wala naman sinabi dyan. Ang tatakbong presidente, puro lang boys. Ang tatakbong vice presidente, puro lang girls. Wala sinabi. Ibig sabihin, the total number, yung pwedeng babae, pwedeng lalaki, tumakbong vice presidente at presidente. So in short, we have 22, no? Total students na pwedeng pagpilian sa pagiging presidente. So 22. So kung yung isa napili na sa pagiging presidente, ilan na lang ang pwedeng mong pagpilian sa vice presidente? Ilan na lang? Andiyan pa ba kayo? Kung ang total number of students sa klase ay 22. Okay, 10 plus 12, that is 22. So, ang pagpilian natin sa pagiging presidente ay 22. No? Pwede silang lahat tumakbo ng pagka-presidente. Ngayon, kung isa sa kanila ay tumakbo na sa pagiging presidente, ilan na lang ang pagpilian natin sa pagka-vice-presidente? 21. Okay, so that is 21. So therefore, 21 times 22, this will give us how many choices? 21 times 22, this will give us 462 ways. Ayan, ito. Sige, para sa inyo na to, ha? Ayan. Ganun, the same situation. How many ways can a class select a muse and an escort? So, isang muse and at the same time, another is an escort. Sa ating chat box, ilan? Warren, 380. Anyone? Any guess? Si Maurice, 20. Bakit 380, ano? Warren? Ah, oh, 380 din si Leonard. 20 times 19. Okay. 20 si Maurice. Okay. Analyze natin ang question palagi. Alam mo, itong mga permutation na to, kung gusto niyo magiging mag-take ng LET, no? Licensure examination for teachers, kalimitan nito lumalabas. Itong permutation, combinations, principles of accounting, ito yung mga basic. Kailangan lang natin i-analyze. Since Muse, sino lang ba ang pwede? Saan ba tayo pipili ng Muse? So sa 10 girls lang. Pwede bang pumili na Muse sa lalaki? Definitely hindi, no? So, okay, so Muse, 10. Sa escort, so definitely saan tayo pipili? Dito lang sa 12 boys. 12. So 10 times 12, that will give us 120 ways. Okay? Ayan. So, naintindihan? Next. Ah, hindi. Okay na pa kanina. Next. Okay. In this case, the new standard configuration for the Philippine license plate is 3-letter followed by 4 digits. ABC, 1, 2, 3, 4, na yung example. Ang tanong, number one, letter A, how many different license plates are possible if letters can be repeated? Well, guess. So, ibig sabihin, maglagay tayo dito, ha? So, sabi ang format, si J. Ford. Okay. So, ang first 3 daw, ito puro letters, ha? Puro letters to. Lagyan natin ng L letters. Ang sunod na ano sa plate number, 4 numbers, ito N. Okay. How many letters are we in the alphabet na pwede ba nating i-utilize so sa paggamit ng or pag-create ng license plates? We have 26, di ba? Tama ba 26? So we have 26. Okay. Pwede namang magparehas, pwede naman AAAA. So definitely 26 din pwede natin pagpilian dito, 26. Then dito, ang pagpilian natin na numbers ay 0 to 9. So we have 10 numbers na pwedeng pagpilian. Tama? So i-multiply, roll of the product. 26 times 26 times 26 times 10 times 10 times 10 times 10. How many combinations?
175,760,000 po.
Okay, very good. Ito, letter B. So, ang kuha dito is 175,760,000. Okay. Ito, how many different license plates are possible if letters and digits cannot be repeated? Ano magiging setup dito? cannot be repeated. So, ang una nating pagpilian sa first, 26. Pero kung hindi maulit, ang sunod nating pagpilian ay minus 1, 25. O kung hindi na maulit, minus 1 ulit, magiging ng 24. So ibig sabihin, kung gamit mo na si A dito sa una pa lang, ah? So 25 na lang ang pagpilian. Hindi mo na pwedeng isama si A. Kung si A and B gamit na, 24 na lang ang pagpilian para dito sa pangatlo. Ganon din dito sa numbers. So ang unang pagpilian, 10. Kung not, cannot be repeated, 10. So 9, 8, and 7. Rule of the product ulit. Ano yung sagot nito? Twenty-six times 25 times 24 times 10 times 9 times 8 times 7.
78,624,000.
Okay. Very good. Ayan. So yan po ang principles of counting. Madali lang, di ba? Sobrang dali. Now, punta tayo sa permutations and combinations. Tandaan po natin sa permutations and combination. Okay, magkaiba po to sila, no? Ang permutation, very particular sa arrangement. Ang combination, walang pake sa arrangement. Okay? So by definition, our permutations is associated with arranging things in different order. Combinations of number, the main concern for combination is just simply concern of combining things. No? So for permutations, order matters, but for combination, the order does not matter. No? So, ayan. So the best way to explain with this particular concept is by giving you an example, guys. Say, for example, so we have here letter. Now, let's say we have three letters, no? A, B, C. We could arrange, no, these letters A, B, C, or pwede natin, we could say C, A, B, ayan, and so on and so forth. Now, even if we have the same three letters, the order is different. Ibig sabihin, this two combination, these two arrangement are different when we talk about permutations. Kasi permutation is different. Permutation is simply concerned with regards to arrangement. So, the number of permutations, in this case, mayroon dahil tayong 2. Kung we have 3 letters ABC, CAB, ano pa ba? Ang pwede nating makombine sa ABC na to. So pwedeng ABC, what you call this? ACB, ABC, ACB, B, B is BAC, BCA. Pwedeng C, C, CAB, CBA. Okay. So in this case, we have 6 possible arrangements na. 6 possible arrangements. Okay. So another things that we have to look into. in mathematics, we use more precise language, no? When the order does not matter, anong para saan siya nag ano? Sa combination ng ano yan. Combination na formula ang nagamitin natin. When order does not matter, permutation pa tayo. Okay? So, a permutation is an ordered combination. Okay? So, yun yung to help us remember, no? Regarding permutation, we are talking about parang position, na ano yan, ABC, pagkatapos, kung saan siya nakalagay. Very particular si permutation na yan. Pero si combination, hindi eh. Kunyari, ang isang, may apat na tao. Okay. Kahit pagbaliktad-balikta rin na yun, apat pa rin sila. Okay. Sa combination. Pero sa permutation, kung pagbalik-balikta rin natin yung position nila, arrangement matters. Pero sa combination, kahit pagbalik-balikta rin pa natin, apat, walang mangyayari, walang kakaibahan, sila pa rin niya. Okay? So, yun yung kakaibahan, no, ng combination sa permutations. So, okay. So, katulad din kanina, so we have here ABC and say AB. Pagpalagay natin, may tatlong tao, ABC. Tapos, CAB. Sila pa rin tatlo yan. Sa combination, iisa lang. No? Isang ano lang yan. Walang ang count noon. No? Iisa pa lang. They are the same person. Kahit pagbaliktad-balik na rin. Pero sa permutation, magkaiba ang counting natin. Okay. So, let's say, if we have four letters, no, balikan natin kanina. A, B, C, D. So, and let us choose, no, two of the four letters. And how many different ways can we arrange two of the four letters? And also, how many ways or how many different ways can we combine two of the four letters? So we have to make a list, no? And use the to determine the number of permutation, the number of combination of choosing two out of four. Then we will talk about how to use an equation to get the answer. So definitely we can choose AB. We can choose AC. AD. We can choose BC. R. We can choose, of course, BA, BC, BD. We can choose CA, CB, CD. We can choose D. A, DB, and DC. So in this case, guys, na, in this case, we notice that there are 12, no, total of 12 different ways we can arrange two out of four letters. No? So we have, when we talk about number of permutations in this example, okay, we have 12. We have 12 ways to choose two letters out of four. Now, what about combination? If we recall, na, for a combination, the order does not matter. Okay? So, kung permutation ang pag-usapan natin, ilan sila? Ito ay magiging, we have 12, no? Kung permutation, we have 12. Pero, pag ito'y combination, but for combinations, you are combining the same letters, and since the order does not matter, no, for combinations, they are counted once as a combination. So if we are going to count AB, kung ika-count natin to si AB, hindi natin pwedeng i-count si BA. Na? So in-circle natin. Kung i-count natin si AC, hindi natin pwedeng i-count na si CA. Ayan. I-count natin si AD, hindi na natin pwedeng i-count si DA. Pag i-count natin si BC, ay sorry. Lagay na. Ano ko muna ha? Ayan. So kung i-count natin si, saan na yun siya? BC, hindi na natin i-count si CB. Ah, bakit na nga to? BA, BC, ito ay BD to guys ha. BD yan. So kung i-count natin si BD, hindi na natin dapat i-count si DB. Pag i-count natin si CD, hindi na natin dapat i-count si DC. So kung pagbisihan natin ang combination, ilang combination lang? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 combinations. 6 possible combinations. To choose 2 out of 4 letters. So now we can see or we can clearly see the difference between permutation and combination. So just remember our permutation, the order matters. In combination, the order does not matter. So now we can calculate no, these answers in an easier way, which we can find the value as opposed to making a list as of all possible possibilities. So say for example, na, so sa, ang formula natin sa permutation, that is NPR. Ito yung formula natin sa permutation. Ang formula naman doon sa, okay, that this NPR, okay, or that is equivalent to N factorial over N minus R factorial. So definitely, okay, so, balikan natin yung kanina, no? Na may apat na letters tapos kukuha lang tayo ng dalawa, no? Okay, so that is actually 4. N here is 4, no? P2. No? So we have 4 factorial over 4 minus 2 factorial. So this will give us, I'm sorry, this is 4 minus 2. So this will give us 4 times 3 times 2 factorial, 4 minus 2, 2 factorial. Okay, cancel, cancel. This will give us 12 ways. So may 12 ways. Ganun lang, instead na listing. Sa ano guys, sa pangalan nito, sa combination, the formula is NCR is equals to, okay, if you are familiar with the Pascal formula na. So that is NCR over N factorial over N minus 2, okay, N, sorry, bakit 4 naman to? N minus R factorial, R factorial. So this is the Pascal formula actually. And at the same time, this is the formula for combinations. So ganun din kanina. Okay, so we have 4 factorial. Ay, sorry. 4 factorial in half. Forget about yung tuldok. 4 factorial over 4 minus 2 factorial. 2 factorial. So this will give us, okay, so we have 4 minus 2. That is 4 times 3 times 2 factorial over 4 minus 2 factorial, 2 factorial, 2 factorial. Cancel ko lang tong dalawa. So this will give us 12 over 2. 2 factorial is 2 times 1. That is, that will give us 2. No? So we have 12 divided by 2, that is 6. Ayan. So we have 6 na. So tandaan natin. Permutations, 12, sa listing method, sa combination 6. Ganun din pagdating sa gamit na yung ating formula. Huwag kalimutan ha, this is the formula in finding out the permutation. This is the other formula in finding out combination. Questions? May tanong? Walang tanong. Yan ang gusto ko. Walang nagtatanong. Okay. So, ito. Sa ating chat box. Kayo nang bahala. I-determine nyo to. Ano to? Permutation or combination? In how many different ways can you arrange 3 books on the shelves? From a group of 7. Okay, sige. Sa ating chat box. Anong sagot? Okay, ano na sagot? Anyone? Maurice. Si Shen, 5,040 din. Bakit 5,040? Okay. Ayan, parang meron ako nakita. Warren, tama ka, 210 ways. This is actually permutation. Pag may nakita kang arrangement na word, ibig sabihin yan, definitely, ito ay masolve, no, gamit ang permutation formula. Okay? So we have 7P3, or that is 7 factorial over 7 minus 3 factorial. Okay? So this will give us 7 times 5 times 6. 7 minus 3, that is 4. No? Sorry, mali. So that 7 factorial is 7 factorial. Ha? Pag sinabi natin 7 factorial, that is actually equivalent to 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Okay, that's 7 factorial. So 7 factorial, Kaso lang minsan hindi ko na masyado kasi mahaba. So 7 - 4, that is 7 - 3 is 4 factorial. So 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 factorial over 4 factorial, cancel ko na yan, cancel. That is 5 times 6, that is 30 times 7. This will give us 210 ways. 210 lang, hindi 5,040. Okay? Another example pa ha. Another example. In how many different ways can we arrange 5 books on a shelf? Five books on the shelves. Jayford, 120. Maurice, 120. Ayan. Actually, pwede niyong gamitan to ng principles of counting para ma-solve. Pero pwede rin permutations. Yes. Ayan. So in this case, okay. How do you think, no? The problem differs from the previous problem. Is this still a permutation? Yes, this is still a permutation. May word na arrange siya. Arrange. That means that order matters. It is still a permutation, no? But you can use the fundamental counting principles, no, to get the answer. So what we want here is to arrange 5 books on the shelves. So right there, we have 5 position. May 5 position pa tayo. So sa principles of accounting, ang gagawin lang po natin, we have 5 positions for 5 books na. What we are going to do here is just to have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. 20 times 3, this will give us 60, and this will definitely give us 120 ways. Sa principles of counting. Na? However, pwede din gawin natin, pwede natin din siyang isolve through permutation formula. This is actually gamit yung NPR, n factorial over n minus r factorial. So we have 5. Okay. 5 factorial over 5 minus 5 factorial. So 5 factorial over 0 factorial. 0 factorial is 1. So this is equivalent to 5 factorial, 1 factorial. Ano, that's 1, 0. Erase ko lang yung factorial. So 0 factorial is 1. So definitely, so 5 factorial, that is, okay, 5. Ito na nga, 125 factorial is 5 times 4 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 over 1, or that is 120 over 1, or that is 120. So the same, 120. Magaling. Next, ito naman, how many teams of 4 can be produced from a pool of 12 engineers. Ang unang tanong, permutation, combination. Lagay niyo sa chat box. Pangalawang tanong, how many teams of 4 can be produced from a pool of 12 engineers? Okay, combination. Yes, that is a combination. Shan, shan. Okay, go ahead. Kung combination siya, okay, ano yung sagot? Sige, sa ating chat box, sinong gustong mag-share, no? Baka mayroon kayo diyang ano, papel, ayan. Tapos i-ano niyo. I-share niyo dito sa ating chat box. Ipakita niyo sa akin yung formula ng combination at kung paano niyo nakuha yung total number of teams. Okay. Tapos na? Share naman dyan pagtapos na. Sabi natin combination, no? Kasi order does not matter here. So if we choose, no, 4 individuals, pagpalagay natin si John, Zio, Sally, and Chris, does it really matter if we select John, Sally, Chris, and Zio? Ibang arrangement, di ba? Hindi. So definitely this is a combination. So the order does not matter. So we have to choose 4 out of 12. So definitely this is 12C4. Or that is 12 factorial over 12 minus 4 factorial 4 factorial. So if that would be the case, 12 minus 4, that is 8 factorial na. So that is 12 times 11 times 10 times 9 times 8 factorial over 12 minus 4, 8 factorial. And 4 factorial is 4, that's the 4 factorial. So may 8 factorial dito, i-cancel ko. 12 times 11 times 10 times 9. Calculator. So we have 12 times 11 times 10 times 9. The answer is 11,880. 4 factorial, 4 times 3, 12 times 2, 24. Times 1, 24 pa rin. Tama ba yan? Divided by 24. Ay, sorry. Sana ba yun? Ang hirap mag ano, divided by 24. The answer is 495. Tama? Check nyo kung tama ba yung ano ko. Ay, dami na pala na. Okay, so 495. Oh, tama na. Okay. Oh, yun naman pala. Okay. Another example, ha? Another example. In how many ways can you arrange the letters in the word Alabama, Mississippi? Ito ay permutation, may word arrange. Sige. Pag ganitong case, guys, may mga letters, no? Sa permutation, ang ano nito is, ilang sa letter A, ang paraan dito para madali, bilangin natin ilan yan. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, we have 7 factorial. Over, ilang A? 4. So, kung ano yung repeat na letters, bibilangin mo lang din. Okay, so 4 yung A, yung L, iisa lang. Pwedeng 1 factorial. B, isa lang din. Pwedeng 1 factorial. M, 1 factorial. So, yung 1 factorial na yan, kahit hindi mo na isama yan, kasi 1 pa rin naman yan. Wala nang maging ano dyan. So, ito na lang, 7 factorial over 4 factorial. So, this will give us 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 5 times 6 times 5 times 4 factorial over 4 factorial. Cancel, cancel. 30 times 7, this is 210 ways. For letter B, sige nga. Sige, sa letter B, what would be the answer? Sinagutan ko na yung letter A, so madali na lang. What would be the answer for letter A? What would be the answer? How many different ways can we arrange the letters in the word Mississippi? So 11 letters, no? Tama ba? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Ano? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 11. Okay. Okay, si J Ford, tama. 34,650. Na? Paano naging 34,000? That is 11 factorial over. Ilang M? 1 factorial. So hindi ko na isama yung tigwa 1. Doon na lang ako sa I. Ilan yung I? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 4 factorial. Yung S, another 4. 4 factorial. I, S. Ilang P? 2. Ayan. Sige nga.
Pero,
ayan. So, ang sagot, Tamang sagot ay 34,650. Very good. Okay? Ayan. So sige. Ito set work natin. Madalian lang ha, so 12 bago mag dapat maano niyo to, masagutan niyo bago mag 12:15. Hindi. So ang una ko dito na ano madalian lang ha. Madalian. Number one. In how many ways can four books be arranged on a shelf? Shelf yan ha. Ayan ha. Pangatlo. Pangalawa. Ayan. In how many ways can three students be seated in a row? So number one, in how many ways can four books be arranged on a shelves? So kumuha kayo ng pangalan nito. Yellow pad or whatever mayroon kayo dyan. Pwedeng notebook, picturean nyo, ilagay nyo, i-ano nyo sa ating chat box. In how many ways can three students be seated in a row? Number three. Yes.
Sino pa ang composer at ayos? Kung pwede po makaumis, ano sir? Sa mga bakit? Sa mga pakiramdam ko, sir, paano ang composer at ayos po?
Sige.
Iwanan ka lang po siya ng gawain yung bata. Pakainin ko po siya.
Ano na naman yan?
Sini? Si Paul. Sakit ng ulo ko.
Uminom ka na ng gamot.
Opo. Okay lang po, sir.
In how many ways can five be filled, huh? With 12 men So number three, in how many ways can five starting positions, on a PBE team be filled with 12 men who can play any of the positions? And number four, Ayan. Sige, yan na lang apat. Number four, in how many permutations can be made from the letters in the word Sunday if four letters are used at a time? B, all letters are used. C, all letters are used, but the first is a vowel. Okay? So, 12-19. Ayan. So, antayin ko yung inyong mga solusyon in, actually, madali lang to eh, in 5 minutes, no? At 12-25. Ayan. I-post niya sa ating chat box kung tama ba yung inyong mga set words. With solution, yes. Makita ang solution. Oh, So for number one, in how many ways can four books be arranged in shelves? So madali yan, pwede yung ano na, yan, 4 factorial over 4 minus, ano yan? Mali ka nga. Oo. Bakit 1 yun? Okay, so that is supposedly, ang sagot sa number one is, yung kanina, mayroon akong example niyan kanina, di ba? Pwedeng sagutan to through principles of counting or through permutations. That is actually 4 factorial. Na 4 factorial. That is 4 times 3, 12 times 2, 24. So the correct answer for number 1 is 24. Asan ba yun? Ano natin? So for number 1, that is actually NPN. Na NPN. So that is 4 factorial over 4 minus 4 factorial, or that is 4 factorial over 0 factorial. So the 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 over 1. 0 factorial is 1. So this will give us 4 times 3 times 2. 24 over 1 or 24. So the correct answer is 24. Pwede rin sa principles of counting, diretsahin mo na lang, di ba? That is 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 or 24 pa rin. Number 2, no? In how many ways can 3 students be seated in the row? 3 students be seated in the row. So, pwede rin to sa principles of counting, pwede sa permutation. So 3, no? Pwedeng 3p3, or that is 3 factorial over 3 minus 3 factorial. This will give us 3 times 2 times 1 over 0 factorial, or that is, this will give us 6 no, over 1, or the correct answer is 6. Yeah. So for number 3, ang sabi, in how many ways? In how many ways can we select 5 positions? 5 starting positions in the PBA team be filled with 12 men na, who can play any of the positions. So permutations, 12 p ilan 5, so that is 12 factorial over 12 minus 5 factorial. This will give us 12 times 11 times 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 factorial over 7. So over 12 minus 5, this is 7 factorial. 7, cancel natin. So 12 times 11 times 10 times 8 times 9. Anong sagot? That is 95,000. 40 ways. Okay, so sa number 4, ang tanong ay how many permutations can be made from the letters in the word Sunday if 4 letters are used at a time? 4 letters are used at a time. So 4 letters are used at a time. So madali lang to, di ba? This is 6p4, no? 4 letters. So this is 6 factorial over 6 minus 4 factorial. This will give us 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 factorial over 2 factorial. Cancel, cancel. 12 times 5. Actually. So this will give us 360 ways. 30 times 4, 120. Times 3, 360. So, sa letter A ito. For letter B, ang sabi, all letters are used. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 na. All letters are used. So, that is 6P6. Ang 6P6, alam naman natin na that this is actually equivalent to 6 factorial. Diretsuhin na lang natin, hindi na natin. So, that is actually 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, this will give us 720 ways. Tama ba? 720. Okay. Sa letter C, ano yung sabi ng letter C? All letters are used, but the first is a vowel. Okay. Take note ha, sa word na yan, the first letter of its permutation, is to be either sa Sunday na word, U or A. Dalawa lang naman ang anong dyan, vowel. So, U or A, Sunday. So, may dalawang vowel lang po tayo, U and A. Ang tanong, okay, we want to, how many permutations can be made into letters in the word Sunday if all letters are used, but the first is a vowel. Okay. So we have, again, therefore, we have two choices for the first letter. No? U and A. So after selecting the first letter, we can select how many? The remaining five. Okay. Five with restriction. So consequently, ang ibig sabihin noon, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, okay. So, we have two na pagpilian, actually. So, this is two. Okay. U and A. Okay. Na pagpilian. Two factorial. So, that is two times. Kung gagamit natin yung two, okay. Kung gagamitin natin yung isa, ilan yung pwede natin pagpilian? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, times 5, ay sorry, 5 factorial. So, 5 factorial. Yan yung ano natin dito. So, kung dalawa, yung una ang vowel ay isa. So, 2 times 5 factorial. So, this will give us 2 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. What would be the answer? 20, 60, 120, 240. Tama ba? 240 ways, yes. Tandaan nyo, dapat tandaan nyo palagi yung ano. I-ano natin yung pangalan nito. Kung paano, paano natin sagutan yung ano. We have to understand the problem. Well, so sino yung nakasagot ng tama? Tingnan nga natin, 730, 720, nasagot. Okay. Ayan, so, nasagot yung first two sa number 4, A and B. Pero yung letter C ang hindi nasagot. Tingnan nyo yung letter C ha, kung may encounter kayo na gano'n ng tanong, yan po ang atake natin sa pagsagot. Okay? So, ayan. So, since tayo ay it's time for us to play again. Madali lang po itong laro na to, no? Sige. Maglaro na po tayo, guys. Doon sa... Ano muna tayo? Permutation muna tayo. Sana hindi... Madaliin lang yung tanong ang sagot, ha? So, 10 minutes siguro. Wait lang, asaan na yung aking quizzes? So magpa-live quiz ako ha. Start live. Nice. Oh, laruin niyo, mabilisan lang to ha. Mabilisan. Oh, join na kayo agad sa ano natin. Yan yung code natin, nalagay ko na dyan sa ating chat box. Join na po kayo. This is all about permutation. I-start ko na siya, ha? Habol na lang yung iba. Para, ayan. Start ko na. Para, habol na lang yung iba, ha? Para makapagsagot na agad. Thank you. mayroon pang dalawa na hindi pa natapos, tapos sila. Na guys, yung iba may dalawa pa, si Muda at saka si ano, ano to, wala na. Nawala na internet. Okay. Sige. So, yan po yon. I-review natin, no? May time pa ba tayo? Quick questions. Review natin yung questions. How many ways can a club president select a president, vice president, and a secretary sa tatlo from a group of 5 people? Okay, so that is 5, no? 5 times 4 times 3, that is 60. Okay. How many ways can we arrange the letters in the word ma, no? Of course, again, that is 24. 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Okay, what is 10? P5 means permutation of 10 choices and 5 positions. How many outfits are possible in 5 pairs of jeans? 8 t-shirts and 2 pair of shoes. So that is 5 times 8 times 2, 80. In how many ways can you arrange 7 people to be seated in the round tables? Kung round table, guys, ganito ang tandaan. N minus 1 yan palagi. So ang N natin is 7 minus 1, 6. N minus 1 factorial. So that is 6 factorial, which is equivalent to 720 ways. Calculate the number of 3-digit numbers that can be formed using a digit of 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9 without repetition. So 3-digit numbers that can be formed using the digits 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. So ilan yung numbers na yan? 5, no? Tatlo ang gagamitin without repetition. So kung may tatlo, 5, so that is, yun nga, 5 times 4, 20 times 3 ulit, 60. Team A consists of 6 players, which is to have badminton matches with Team B, which consists of 7 players. Okay, calculate the number of single matches. Single matches, 6 times 7, 42. Dali lang, di ba? Calculate the number of ways how four different prizes be given to 4 participants. Okay, so in a quiz, so that's 4 times 3 times 2, 24. Homecoming has 7 candidates for king. How many ways can a king and a first runner-up be chosen to form the festival court? Okay. Homecoming has 6 candidates for king, no? 7. How many ways can a king and a first runner-up be chosen to form a festival court. So king and first runner-up, so that 7 sila. So 7 ang pagpilian sa una, times sa pangalawa sa pagiging first runner-up, 6 na lang. So 7 times 6, 42. 7P2, okay, 42. 7P2 is 42. Okay? So, yun lang naman. Okay, 10 questions lang pala yung ano natin. So, it's already 1. Any other, mayroon akong i-share na mga pangalan nito na inyong paglaruan, guys, no? Bago kayo mag-exam sa Friday. Siguraduhin ninyo, laruin nyo muna po ang ating questions na sa quizzes. Tapos kung hindi niyo naintindihan, pwede niyo naman, guys, i-Google na lang yung questions. So kung hindi maiintindihan, Google niyo lang, tapos paano nakuha yung sagot, no? Ganun nga. Okay, so what else pa ba ang ano natin? So maraming medyo nahirapan. Ang accuracy, class accuracy rate natin is 54. Ibig sabihin, dapat kasi maka 75 tayo. So ibig sabihin 54 lang ng klase percent, no? Medyo nakakuha ng sa konsepto ng principles of counting, permutation, and combinations. Sige, after ng ano natin, ng exam, ulit-ulitin ko pa rin sa inyo kasi ito ay mahalaga, no? Sa ating buhay. So, will the exam be online? Ano ba yung exam ninyo? Yung exam ko dito ngayon, ano ba instructions? Itanong ko muna kay Sir Reggie. Pero ngayon, ang exam ninyo nasa online, naka-ready na yan sa Friday. Kayo nang bahala dyan. Nakalagay na yan, nakalagay na dito. Nakaschedule na sa akin yung exam niyo. Mag-open na yun sa Friday, 11 o'clock. Okay? So, bago mag-Friday, mag-share pa ako ngayon ng ating mga reviewers na para mag-review kayo. Ano? Permutation, yung nakaraan ha, mga propositions, yung lahat ng mga sinishare ko na video, kailangan nyo yung tingnan, no? Para naman pagdating na exam ay perfect po tayo. Okay? So, review ng review lang. Okay? Sige. So, it's 103. Okay? Kaya left another choice. We have to end up this class. Pero mag-share ako ng mga videos at the same time, mga question, mga review questions na para sa ating exam. Huwag niyong kalimutan laruin, ha? Okay, so that's all po muna. Thank you and bye-bye.
Thank you, sir. God bless po.
Thank you, sir.